Hello guys, this is GWS, and we're going to be playing some Democracy 3 from a political enthusiast himself. So, for those of you watching, and those of you who may be new to my politics, I'm kind of centrist, slightly to the right, conservative, and I just want to show people just how you can get things done with kind of a slightly right-leaning political agenda. Now, I will say this game's like, it's not a perfect simulation. I think it's slightly biased to the left, but that's another story entirely. So we're going to play as the U.S. because that's similar to our current situation. And let's just read some of these things. 316 million, size 9.8 million square miles, 78.6 life expectancy, Gini coefficient about 50, 47.7, 49K GDP per capita, poverty about 16%, a little bit, that sounds a little bit high, we don't usually get beyond 15, 79.9% white, 78.3% Christian, 30.6% obesity rate, Big Mac index $4.20, or $4.02, I think that actually is. Because, beef consumption, 57.4 pounds per person. This is actually an amazing game. You're going to see why. Because, it's like I said, it's not a perfect simulation. We're not going to play a monarchy mode. We're going to try to simulate winning elections. We got disasters on hurricanes and earthquakes. Difficulty 100%. 100% innate socialism, 58% political apathy, sounds about right for the U.S., so we'll keep that as it is. Innate liberalism, 100%, we're going to keep it as is, because, and we're going to put this as realistic as we can, so I'm going to be Republicans. I'm not a Republican in real life, but let's just be honest, you'd have to run as a Republican to win, so in any alternate universe where I run as a politician, I would be a Republican. And then, of course, running against the Democrats. Now, I am changing this because, this game runs in quarters, and if you got 4 years in four quarters, that's like 16 policy rounds that you get. And so I just don't think that's enough. And we're also going to have unlimited term limits. So, you know, it's not a perfect simulation, you know, I could go with two, because that's, if you're not from the U.S., that's our term limits, but we're going to go with unlimited, because I want to see how many elections that we can win, although I'm not going to obviously stream the whole thing, at least not at once. Might make it a multi-parter, I don't know, depends what I want to do. So, anyhow, let's click play, and we're going to start seeing, I like these here, misinterpreting the Constitution, preparing sound bites, briefing against colleagues, gerrymandering constituencies, you know, kind of making fun of the political situation. So congratulations on your election victory. We're not going to read all that, but here's some basic figures. GDP, lowish, health, very low, education, kind of high, unemployment, medium, crime, very high, poverty, toward the medium side. So, okay, now, before we explain my policy strategy, let's just kind of give you a rundown on what all these icons are, if you've never played this game. The blue icons are data. So if I click on something like here, this is oil demand. You can't directly control this. So here are all the causes. This is what's causing oil demand to be what it is. And the red means it's causing it to decrease. And this number of parentheses is the number, as it'll say here, of inertia, which means what you see here, like anything, has 8 years of lag. So, like, say there's a change in biofuel subsidies, for example, that, like, causes this to increase for whatever reason, or, like, it brings it down here, then that takes 8 turns for it to actually have an impact on oil demand. And all these are, of course, zero. And of course, the greens are causing it to increase, so car usage obviously causes a lot of oil demand. And here's the effects right here. And it only has one effect on here, oil price, causing it to increase because supply and demand. Now, if you click on any one of these, so you click on, for example, oil price, you can see causes and effects of this. So then, you know, you can keep clicking through all this. Oil supply, which does not have cause and effect for whatever reason, but it does have an effect, and that's causing the oil price to drop. See, a lot of this too will probably have to do with the like, you could look at charts here, and this will show well, this isn't yeah, I think you have to look at the world economy here. Let's see, I forgot. What was the world economy? Here's intelligence briefing. Let's see. Here's basically focus groups. I don't really get too much into that. There's a tutorial. Get out of my face. Thank you. Yeah, see, so, you know, there's a lot of little graphs here that you could play with. And then you have, okay, yeah, it's right here, duh. And here you can kind of see your economic stuff. And this is going to be interesting, too, because we want to pay attention to this debt, because, like, see, the key thing here is, like, managing your debt while you're doing certain things. So, okay, well, let me go through what the rest of these are. Okay, the whites are your variable things. These are causes that you directly have. So, like, you can play with these little knobs and raise and lower a particular policy. For example, you know, of course, biofuel subsidies. I can actually raise and lower this. So if I lower this, these lighter green parts, that's going to be the effect. And of course, this number of parentheses is going to be the number of turns it takes to obtain that effect. You know, the inertia aspect of it. But we're not going to do that right now. And then, of course, there's three numbers here, raise, lower, and cancel. And what this is, it's called political capital. So you have, beside this fist here, you have number 24. This is the amount of political capital you have. So if you, say, raise or lower a certain tax or a certain subsidy, that takes away from that. And how do you get political capital? Well, you got to hire a bunch of shills that pretty much represent you. Now, in this game, they're all pretty much random. They all have loyalties, and they have desired jobs, and all these kind of affect both how much political capital they produce and how efficient they are at ordering what you want. So if I click on, say, let's click on rail subsidies here. 26%, costs plus 6%, effects minus 17%, implement time plus 17%. A lot of this will be, in fact, impacted by his experience. His experience, as well as if it's his preferred job. So, like, if you hire somebody unqualified, he's going to give you a lot of political capital, but you're not going to have much of anything. Okay, now what are these red ones? These red ones are the critical problems of the nation, and these are basically the things that you're going to want to solve. And so, like, here is homelessness. And this is basically, it's the same thing as the blue icons, except for these have start and stop triggers. Now, of course, the start trigger here is like when, you know, you see back here when it starts increasing at the beginning before we touch the simulation. Like, this increases over the red line, and that creates a problem. And these effects are only in place as long as this is above the stop trigger, which causes it to be a problem. So let's look at the problems of our nation. So we got homelessness, we We got pollution. We got uncompetitive economy. We have a skill shortage. And you see, most of these are pretty similar to problems that exist today. You got drug addiction. You have an asthma epidemic. You have vigilante mobs, basically gangs. You have antisocial behavior. You have alcohol abuse, which is like off the charts. And you got internet crime. And so these are the critical issues that you're going to want to solve, but you're going to want to solve a little other things too. Like, there's a lot of things that won't be on this list. Like, for example, if I can find it, stuff like your poverty rate. So, well, hang on, I know how to find one. Okay, this is one, this is big for me. This is unemployment, which is slightly on the higher end of average. You see causes and effects here, but this is an example of a negative data point that you want to decrease. For some reason, GDP is driving that way up. I guess because our GDP is not high enough. Okay. So, basically, let me just explain. Like, you know, like, if I were a liberal and I saw a lot of these problems, you know, of course, what you're going to want to do is you're going to want to spend a bunch of money. So you're going to want to just tax a bunch, and then you're going to want to throw money at everything. But in this game, just like in real life, the whole key is to min-max. Min-max meaning, like, find the smallest possible things that you can do for people that cost the least amount of money but have the highest impact. So you're initially going to be spending, right? And this kind of parallels to real life, too, because, like, if you were to ever replace the social structure, say, something like Social Security, you're not just going to want to cut Social Security, no. But you're going to want to put in policies that will supplement everything that it does for a fraction of the cost, and then you start making your cuts once you see those policies established. So, like, you know, if I were a conservative, for example, you know, you see this Juicy Space program here, which, let's be real, we're not spending $79 billion a quarter on our space program, but conservatives would go ahead and lower this. But see, here's a problem, though. Like, with this simplistic conservative solution to cut everything, which is the opposite of spend more money. And that is, you know, well let's look at, like, if you spent more money, see, I could tell you what's going to happen, but we're going to see quickly once we do turns here, is, like, here's our income, here's our expenditures. Like, we're already starting off in debt. That's bad, right? So, like, you know, we keep spending money on this, just to have tiny effects, but we're spending, you know, about $20 billion more, and there's stuff, like, you're not really getting a whole lot out of it. You're getting, this would give, an extra 2.5% technological advantage. It would only decrease unemployment by a very tiny fraction, which, would be about 1%. So, you know, here's what you do. Like, if we want to solve the skill shortage and do other stuff, the first thing you want to do is you want to put in just small things that people are going to like. So, for example, public libraries. Public libraries, $1.21 billion to $19.42 billion. And so, see, this is a very inexpensive way to, you know, because this is going to give us 3.97% if we just spend, $10 billion, and then this gives us 6.13%, increases equality, and, it increases our approval of retired people. well, yeah, not, we'll go over that in a second, but, yeah, let's go over what these are first, because this is going to be important, too. Now, all these groups here, these are groups of voters, and this is all their approval of you. So this isn't just, like, how they're doing. This is just how much they like or dislike you. So, like, as you see with socialists, we're about in a third. Capitalists, about a third. Retired people love us. Commuters, about a third. Patriots love us. State employees love us. Parents hate us. And trade unionists hate us. And liberals hate us, too, naturally. So, you're going to want to do stuff like that. You know, just like little small things that you can do to, do some of that. So you're going to want to do, let's see, this is one liberals won university grants, but look at the cost, $4.86 to $63 billion. That is a lot. So see, just small little things like this. Like this one's $5.34 billion maximum. Very popular with voters. And see, this will solve a lot of problems. This will solve your crime problem like this. You know, minus 5-point-something% crime, and then you get socialists and parents who love us for it. But see, they're not going to love us pretty soon. Because, you know, eventually the cuts are going to come, but the question is, when? So, community policing, this is a very important one. See, this is 2 to 15 billion, but look at how much this is going to cut crime and alcohol abuse. So, you crank this all the way up. You know, see, we spent about 50 billion, but look at all we've gotten done. And see, here's telecommuting initiative. We could do that. Like, lots of cheap little things that you can do. You know, kind of like in real life. Like if you, you know, politicians a lot of times try to get the gigantic initiatives done because they want stuff that they can vote on. But, like, a lot of times, sometimes just passing something small would be fine. Like, you know, passing incentives, you know, trying to incentivize things rather than, trying to incentivize things, basically, like, incentivize using, you know, like, less emissions, and in some cases you can regulate it, but, so see, I think we're gonna do telecommuting initiative, because see, these are, like I said, a lot of things, and you're going to see the next few turns, we're actually going to be doing, a lot with crime, because, you know, one area you do want to spend on is crime fighting. And so, of course, this goes by turns, so now we're going to go next turn, and you're going to probably see here, surprisingly it didn't happen yet, but if you stay in debt, your, credit rating's going to go down. So here, now, these are basically, like, specific laws, and they'll come across your desk, like, every quarter or something. You'll get, you may get one, sometimes you won't get any. So this is a debt protection law. So, basically, what this is loan sharking. Like, do you want to regulate what interest rates people could charge, or do you want to have predatory loans? Now, you know, this is an issue I'm very, very, very torn on, because there are extreme cases where you would want such a loan with an extremely high interest rate, because you don't have any way of getting the bulk cash, and you'll pay a huge amount, you know, like 1,000% interest, to have that one bulk sum for that specific thing that you need there and then. But at the same time, like, the actions of these agencies to collect on their debt can be really bad. So this is one instance where I would limit the predatory agency, but it's like, I'm only slightly, very slightly leaned in this direction. Because it's like, I don't like regulating how people do their lives. But see, you're gonna see, like, we're gonna have a fairly conservative society when we're done with this. And so, you know, we're gonna do some other stuff, and see, now you can kind of see what direction things are going to go. GDP hasn't really changed. It's not going to change for a while because, like, there's so many things impacting it. Unemployment's gone down very slightly. How I can even show you my other one. But see, already people are starting to kind of warm up to it. Like, the total popularity's gone up. And so, you know, you're going to see a good mix of stuff. So see, right now, alcohol consumption's still up there, antisocial behavior, that's going to go down very fast because of the stuff. You know, there's a couple things you can learn from this, too. Prisoner tagging. They've even got, like, stuff like private prisons on here, which I'm not for. And as soon as you can get rid of it. But see, another thing, too. And this is the good thing about this game, is priorities. Like, you can't do everything. So, you have to pick what you can do and what there's bigger fish to fry on. And some of this, well, let's look at the skills. That's gonna take a little while. You know, stuff like decreasing taxes or increasing taxes, just stuff like that. Now there's handgun laws, we're gonna keep those. And see, as you can see, some of these things just cost a ton to even change. Which is indicative of real life. Because it's like, you have people on extreme ends of both sides of the spectrum. So like, here's creation versus evolution. This is one of those where bigger fish to fry. Because, yeah, okay, school should teach evolution. And I largely agree with that. Because evolution is... well, we can have a whole debate on that, but it's the closest thing there is to science than creation. And the religious, you know, it's like a lot of it's just a popularity thing. It just has a little bit of an effect on technology, but again, look at the cost, 30. So we'd either have to have some really good advisors that's giving tons of political capital, or we just gotta leave it alone. So... there's that, and then there's stuff like this, like tobacco taxes, and they got, like, car taxes. So, what are we gonna do? The next thing I kinda wanna do, the only problem with this is, like, they kinda roll these, and the liberals so bad right now. Like, yeah, I think I kinda need to do another round of, massaging their needs a little bit, because... You can get assassinated if people hate you too much. I guess it's kind of like in real life. It's like I said, liberals are not going to like me a lot anyhow. So, I'm thinking of doing the environmental stuff right now. And that might have even been what I did before. So... the pollution stuff, like, and here's the thing, too, it's like, carbon dioxide's not pollution, because, of course, you know, I'm a global warming skeptic, which means, you know, the global warming stuff is garbage, but it's like, anything you can do to improve the environment is good, and if you can do that while you're encouraging other things, then that's a good thing, but, yeah, we're gonna go ahead and raise this, because it's very little, it doesn't cost a lot, it has a huge impact, So it's one of those things where you min-max. We can give small business grants. See, I kind of want stuff that liberals are going to want, which is, you know, it's going to be disability stuff and all that, but we're not, like, basically, the big problems are here with, skill shortage, pollution, and the uncompetitive economy, and then right here with the crime, and a little bit here with the, asthma and drugs, which the drugs kind of goes with the crime, and the asthma goes with the environment. So those are two things you kind of want to knock out first, and then you kind of get into your consumer rights, all that, and then you can start lowering taxes, knocking down stuff, paying down your debt that you've incurred, stuff like that. There's import tariffs. We're not going to do that right now. It's a bigger fish to fry issue. Because look at the cost. Well, the cost isn't that much, but... like, you want to be careful with international stuff on this, because you're not really a superpower in this game. Like, you know, other countries can impact you, so I just prefer to leave it alone. So here's one thing that'll kind of help. Most people want it. Enterprise investment scheme, so... you know, this helps entrepreneurs get off the ground. Granted, it's a little bit less than equality, and socialists don't like it right here. But self-employed really like it. GDP, pretty substantial increase, 5%. And it increases earnings. You know, and anything that increases GDP is always good, so we're going to apply that. Let's see, we're actually going to... I think I'm going to do the car emission limits, because this does actually help out a lot. But, ultimately, you know, my goal generally is to get cars off the road as much as possible, because that's going to really... let's see, this is something that's huge for the environment. And the only other thing it really impacts is, like, you know, motorists will like you less. You know, and I don't have any problem with that. So, here's that. So I might even get on the sales tax later. Like, because sales tax has the least impact if you want to raise taxes. You know, and it's like I said, initially that's kind of how you want to do it. Like, if you want a conservative rollover, you have to switch to the more effective policies. So, we've only got four left, so we're going to end the turn right here. Let's return. Ban alcohol adverts. No, we're not banning it. That's not the way to go about it. We're going to control alcohol through law enforcement, give people the free will to decide what they'll do for themselves. And we're getting kind of dangerously close to having to re-roll all this. Because we have two twos and two threes. So we're still getting 25 though, so it's decent. So let's kind of look at this. You want to keep track of this. GDP is not really decreasing, so, or increasing. University grants, healthcare vouchers, adult education. This will help out a lot. This is one of those things where you min-max. It's only $7 billion, but significantly reduces the skill shortage, increases education, increases productivity. You know, always a smart thing. You know, it's always easy to add policies to. That helps out a lot. So here you got tax shelters, foreign investor tax breaks, ag subsidies. Now, going to see some examples, too, of efficient welfare swapping, which you'll see a little bit later, but it's actually a really, really good and efficient balance. Let's see, some of these are banned, like this one requires 27, that's huge, but it does a lot. But anyhow, let's see what we can add. You know, a lot of these are things I'm for. There's a lot of things that were, it's like, you know, I'm not going to go there. You know, even in the game, I'm just not going to go there. So right now, I actually think I'm going to start pounding away at this crime problem. So we're going to add to... Is this our police? Oh, we got community policing. Here's the police. So we want to increase this, because this is what you want to do to decrease crime. It only costs 4 to increase it. And we're going to increase armed police. And yeah, liberals are going to get upset about it. And I might not, that's why I might not do it. Because I don't want to get assassinated. Maybe I'll throw him a bone. Maybe I'll do some recycling. Or I can do some welfare. Something welfare related. I just don't know which one of these specifically will increase the liberal thing. So let's see what liberals hate. See, that's another thing, you can click on this too. And here's happiness influences for this particular group, which is the liberal group. They don't like the alcohol, they don't like the armed police or border controls, they don't like citizenship tests, so they like the, they like immigrants, of course, like real liberals. They don't like the death penalty. Foreign aid, they're okay with. Gated communities, they don't like. Intelligence services, jury trial, legal aid, military spending. That's one thing. It costs a lot to decrease it. But, of course, military spending, we do, just as in real life, spend too much in the military. They like the abortion law. They're going to hate when I change that. And they did like when I banned the alcohol adverts. And they like one of our ministers. Which is good. And I hate the homelessness. So we can click on that real quick. Now, homelessness, like, you just... It's like one of those problems that you just have to solve with just increasing the economy. And you could do stuff like this, too. Relatively cheap measures. A little bit expensive in political points. But free school meals, that's always a good way. It gives a lot of... bonuses, like drastically reduces poverty, increases poor earnings, and increases health as well. The poor like it, and it only costs $7 billion, so why not do it for them? And then I think we're going to start knocking on the police stuff, because now pretty soon we're going to have to do something about the taxes, because even though we're spending... Now, see, here's the credit rating downgrade, and as you can see, it hurts GDP and it hurts capitalism. Now we're a single B in credit rating, which, you know, my credit rating, like in other games I played, you know, it drops down a little bit. It's just, you know, a fact, like it's going to drop down. So there's two ways you can do it. We can raise the income tax, which is very unpopular, costs 30. Or we could raise the sales tax, which is, does a lot less bad to people. So if I were to max this out, 50%, that's quite a sales tax there, but, like, the poor earnings significantly lower. So if we raise this to 450, like, it increases poverty, but it's not, like, crippling yeah, it does decrease it twice as much, but, you know, what are you going to do? Like, it's better that we do it early, too. We get the tax money that we need, as opposed to waiting and then our interest rates, because your interest rate will increase your expenditure, and then you're really having your hand forced. There's not much else we can do right now, so we'll do this. Ban same-sex marriage. We are going to allow it, because, you know, it just, like, same-sex marriage, like, as a real issue, it depends where you're coming at it from. Like, if you're talking about the state should subsidize same-sex marriages, you know, to that person, I'd say, like, what benefit does a same-sex marriage have to society? Because, like, regular marriages, like, you know, yeah, there's exceptions where people can't have children, like women who, you know, get their tubes tied and all that. But in general, you're talking about the nuclear family, the traditional nuclear family, where you have mother, father, plus children, you know. That's the normal nuclear family, and that, at least in theory, it works, but in practice, about 60% end in divorces, so it's like, I don't believe in subsidizing marriage, and therefore there's no reason for the government to recognize it, so. And we're really taking a beating with political capital. Now we're getting 25 a turn. And we only had 2 left before. So now's our opportunity. We can start increasing our actual police force. What's the difference between all these are intelligence services? So you can increase this 3 billion. Dramatically reduces internet crime, but well, we might be able to do both. Let's see. Because, you know, and this is the same thing in life, too. Oh, this is our regular police. Now we want the armed police. Okay, here's liberal crime and violent crime, but liberals hate it. I don't care that they hate it. And we're going to increase our intelligence services. You know, because that is going to help with GDP. You know, now we actually have a surplus. So as you can see, like, you know, conservatives are starting to like me more. Liberals still hate me as much as ever. Look, conservatives actually like me a lot more, so you can already kind of see that we're kind of doing centrist stuff. Centrist, the center right. Let's see, now we can kind of do something like this, because we had all this left. Like notice we don't have to pass that many taxes, we're just passing small things. Like, you know, for example, you know, we can do bus subsidies. You know, and we can do between we could do between 19 and 37 billion. You know, motorists won't like us, commuters will love us, capitalists won't like us that much. Unemployment, a little bit affected. Poor earnings goes up a little bit. And so, you know, and I think bus usage decreases car usage, and that's important. Because ultimately, that's what we want to do. We want to increase the car usage, right? Or we want to decrease car usage, so we decrease pollution. So let's kind of take a peek at this. Our GDP is going up slowly. Pretty soon, we're going to start doing some educational stuff, too. In fact, maybe I'll do that next turn. Briefing against colleagues, turning a blind eye for tax avoidance. Alright, freedom of information. Yeah, we're going to propose the act because we should have freedom of information. As you can see, 2 of our problems have ended. 2 problems we haven't even monitored. And internet crime is going down, so we're starting to solve the crime problem. Alcohol abuse is getting solved partially. Asthma epidemic is going down because our pollution levels are, well, the environment is dramatically increasing. Now car usage, like I said, that's gonna, so you get these, we could do the bus stuff, we can do, plastic bag tax. I think we're gonna go down the, science funding route. There's another one here, too. Labor laws we're not gonna touch yet. Small business grants will get us a small increase in GDP. Dramatic increase in self-employed, which is what you want in a self-determined capitalist society. You want a lot of self-employed people. That's because that's efficient, right? But the problem is the cost you're looking at. Well, it's not actually that expensive, is it? Because you're talking about a lot of self-employed people, a lot of GDP set capitalists. So yeah, we're going to max this out. It only costs us 4 political capital, so we're still at 21, still in good shape. So now we got pollution controls, technology grants, we want this higher. It doesn't really have a lot of an impact, though. So, you know, is it really worth spending the political capital? Probably not. So we can kind of pound away at this education stuff. How's our narcotics doing? Our narcotics are going down. Now see, like, a lot of stuff like GDP, as it goes up, you also have stuff like alcohol consumption and drug use going up too, because people have more money to buy drugs. Now we can start doing some smaller things. You know, like we could do bus lanes, which will only cost us about $5 billion. And it dramatically increases bus usage, which will, in turn, help us out with that. So we can do stuff like even this, like a plastic bag tax. You know, this is actually something I believe in real life too. Like, plastic bags are just they're just bad for the environment. Now, but the thing is, like, I don't know. You know, because this is just people. It actually doesn't improve the environment, does it? I thought it did, but I guess I remembered wrong, didn't I? Okay. And here's another thing, too. This is actually, kind of good. Like, you know, you have just your basic work safety laws. It's going to decrease the self-employed, but it'll increase health a little bit. It decreases productivity, though. Increases trade union membership, which you kind of want in a middle-class society, I guess. You know, I wish it did had a little more of an impact than it did, but, you know, that's, like I said, the game's not a perfect simulation. You know, but this is a lot of stuff I had in my previous game as well. Terrorists captured, and now people love me. You know, even though my poll numbers barely went up. So let's see what we're getting. We're still getting 25 per, which is fine. We don't want to reshuffle anything yet based on that. So you can raise food stamps. This is our food stamps here. Like, we can raise it by 3 billion and we get a small effect. But I think there's still bigger fish to fry than this. There's a lot of little things that could be done still. You know, it's like I said, like, this is just a lot of the little things that you can do. Like, for example, we could do recycling, and this should, yeah, this does significantly improve the environment, and it only has a small cost to it. So, see, I would do science funding. No, but we're going to. Let's see, we're gonna start, let's see, I don't want too many state employees either, because it helps, but, yeah, it's just too much money. It's like I said, there's more effective things that you can do. So those university grants, well, we've already went through that. So we can do ag subsidies, we can do foreign investor tax shelters, consumer rights. I'm actually thinking of doing this one right here, foreign investor. That would really help, because you get money from the foreign investors. Now, we don't have to have it hog wild expensive. This actually does cost a lot of money for what GDP it has. So I think we're just going to keep that to a minimum. 12 billion for that amount. Yeah, it's like, a lot of these two were the when I first started playing too, but yeah, either way, well, let's throw this in too. A lot of this is just feel good stuff, right? Except for racial tension, that's kind of important, because you can have situations pop up. Cost us 210. Liberals love it. They love the equality aspect. So let's see, let's look at our problems. Our uncompetitive economy is almost gone. Pollution's being reduced. Skill shortage going down. Our drug addiction's going down, but it's looking like that's decreased in effectiveness. And there's going to be countervailing measures, as I said before. Our alcohol abuse is down to respectable levels. Unemployment had a sharp drop but hasn't done anything since, and GDP is steadily increasing. Okay, so let's go to our next turn. So our credit rating's back upgraded, so I've actually done better this time while I'm playing with you guys than I did before, largely because I addressed the debt problem previously, right? So skill shortage is almost down. Unemployment hasn't really changed much. So there's just so many policies here that sometimes you'll kind of, like, it's an overload of information, I guess. So a lot of times the best thing is to, see, I did this legalized gambling before, but it really causes you to have to fight organized crime, and that's like if it caused that in real life, it's like you still want to, like, you'd rather have the police and the freedom than no police and no freedom, right? But it's like also, you're trading a lot for zero sum. Like, you're having to spend money for diminishing economic returns. So here's a mansion tax. There's a lot of little taxes here. Ag subsidies. Now, this actually helps out a lot, these rural development grants. So I think we're going to do that. It's expensive politically, but you look at this, you get unemployment down. Farmers are super happy, of course. Poor earnings go up a lot. Equality goes up a lot. Which actually, equality is really helpful because you can raise more taxes. So let's see how close some of these problems are to being solved. Well, we just looked at all that. So, we're going to do that. Skill shortages at an end. Good. Here's GM crops. We're going to allow them because GM crops are overall beneficial. Genetically modified organisms. There's concerns. They should be labeled, but they should exist, absolutely. Like, you don't want to ban GM crops. You got to have them. Okay, well, that just clicked on that. So as you can see, we got a pretty good surplus going here. Because, see, we're tackling the debt ahead of time. So now, and see, you'll even see, like, Laffer curve mechanics, too, with taxes. Like, say you increase taxes above a certain amount, you get penalties to the taxes you create. And in terms of creating, like, a situation, and then you got to find a way to solve that situation in ways other than taxes, right? Okay, so, you know, as you can see, some of this is bottoming out, but some of this is progressively getting better. Alcohol abuse is kind of bottomed out. Internet crime is going down. Pollution's just decreasing gradually. Let's see, this is the uncompetitive economy is see, the corporate tax hurts with that, but we can't really touch the corporate tax yet. We're eventually going to be able to touch a lot of that stuff, but we're going to have to get a lot of this stuff so let's kind of look at this. Violent crime is bottomed out, which actually that's lower than the violent crime usually is. As you can see, crime, because we have more cops, right-wing policy, right? We have more cops, therefore we have less crime. You know, it's simple as that. What's this one right here? Oh, this is emission limits. That's what we did before. So we got school buses here. And see, that's kind of the key behind our pollution strategy, is just to get cars off the road. So here's something we can do, too. See, this is something we can do to cut costs, and it'll also significantly reduce car usage. Like, decrease road building. Now, like I said, this isn't accurate, because it's like, you know, how are you going to decrease road building this much? But, like, in terms of the impacts here, like, this is an example of cutting costs for something and decreasing it. Now, as you can see, it's kind of realistic, too, because while you're cutting car usage, you're not helping traffic, because now the traffic congestion that was prevented from building more roads for more cars, you have eliminated. So the traffic's not going to improve with this, but what is going to improve is the pollution, and that's going to solve a lot of our problems by cutting a cost. And see, that's an important lesson, too. It's like, sometimes you can really, you know, and I'm sure even min-maxing in real life works like that, too. But you know, you can't throw money at everything, and you can't cut everything. It's like you have to have a balance, and you have to have a transition. And that's what a lot of this, you know, game is about. Like, if you're going to transform into an economy that is a certain way, like, you have to have transitional policies. You can't cold turkey just say, we're gonna do X and transform. You know, you have to bridge that gap, if you know what I mean. What's all this other bag tax? It's like we're running out of policies. That's part of the problem. Well, let's see what we want to kind of do for the future, because I think, like, there's a few things we can do here. Like, one of the big things we can do is increase health and privatize some of our infrastructure. You know, we're going to keep the state stuff in, but we're going to privatize everything else. And I think that's where we're going to start. Is, for example, well, here's, okay, here's private schools right here. And then you got vouchers, and you can actually raise vouchers. So you can go all the way there to that. 100-something million. And see, like, once you have the vouchers in place, you can kind of slowly get out of the state-funded schools, and then you switch your education system, and then you address equality in other ways, the problems of equality that you'd face. And here's crime-free utopia. Now here's, yeah, we're gonna have to do something about the work week here. Because see, I mean, this game doesn't quite represent the U.S. because this game has the U.S. as more conservative than it really is. So, you know, here's labor laws. This is something. It's hard to raise it, though, because we don't have the political capital, really. But, you know, we need to put in some, like, worker protections. Like, we've already got one worker protection, but probably next term we're gonna do some of the, other stuff. This homelessness problem, oh, it's almost gone. Poverty went down, but hasn't changed much. Unemployment going down steadily. And so, let's look at what we can do. I know I keep looking at these, but I kind of got to go through my head on a lot of this. Now, we want to be in a position where we can allow things like gambling, which will help GDP a lot. Healthcare vouchers. Very, very expensive. We're going to wait until a lot of that. Here's a flat tax, which I don't really think works in real life. I think if you're going to tax differently, you'd go to a consumption tax, not a flat tax. And it's like I said, they got that there. We just raised our stuff. So small things you can do. Like, you can do a disability benefit here, which is small. And it increases equality. So you can do, you know, it's just like small welfare things. Like, we don't want to do that because we want to have money to, do what we was going to do. So you could do winter fuel subsidy, which helps with with this, and the cool thing about this is, I might show you this or next turn or something, but I'll just tell you, you can, because the retirement love this winter fuel subsidy, you can actually reduce their pensions, and there's not a lot of a net loss for them. Like, this reduces poverty, increases health, and that's always good. And we're still making monster amounts of money. So we're going to go ahead and skip ahead here. Because we want to do the vouchers. That's the first thing we want to do. Homelessness is at an end, which is good. Safeguard oil supplies. Do not deploy troops. Yeah. Now, the only thing is, if this is about purely... protect them from attack by terrorists. Now, see, I don't know, this is kind of a touchy subject. If you have to have that oil. But then again, it's we want to be non-interventionist, so we're not going to do it. Even though it's going to hurt the country overall. But we're trying to get off cars anyhow, so... there's that, too. So let's see. Now let's just kind of take a look at our key metrics here. Here's GDP. GDP went down slightly last quarter, but it's kind of fine, though. Unemployment continues to drop, which is good. Now let's look at earnings. Now here's high earnings. As you can see, high earnings has increased. Poor earnings has dramatically increased. And middle earnings has stayed about the same, which I'm actually shocked at because, I have education stuff in. So, I think we're going to do the labor stuff first, actually, before we go into vouchers, because, that stuff's also taking a while. But here's work safety, and so we just did, it's balanced. What's this, all this, the investor, and this is small business. This is technology. Why didn't I raise? Oh, because it's not really gonna impact much. Okay, here's the labor laws. Now this, we want to be slightly pro-employer, because that's kind of what I am in real life. It's pretty much about here is probably where you want to be in life. And it kind of works that way, too, because, you're still having a decent work week, but you're not... allowing employers to work people to death, basically. And that's kind of the standard that we have right now. And it only slightly has a deterrent to trade union membership, to socialism, to wages overall. It has a better impact than that. But it's still, a slight pressure on wages, which you want to put pressure on workers to have to compete a little bit. But the whole thing is, you want employers to be competing for people, not the other way around. So we're going to do that. Which is really going to provide a boost for us. Now we can actually do this other thing I was looking at. What was it? Yeah, it was technology grants. So yeah, we can actually raise this. And there's another thing here too, technology schools. Here's abortion. Here's adult education. Something we already signed. Okay, yeah, here's technology colleges. We can also increase this a little bit. That might have actually been better, but... it's only cost us a couple billion, and look at technology going up. We'll find places to use that, so no worries. I think we're going to go up to the election, too. As you can see, our credit rating upgraded again. Our credit rating is now single A. GDP increasing. Oops, keep clicking on that. Now, as you can see, our expenditure is not actually increasing a lot because our interest rate keeps going down, right? So let's look at this. Just pay attention to this blue one here. Of course, this is our income. Our income kind of went down a little bit. Our expenditure is steadily increasing, but our interest rate's dropping because our credit rating is lower, or our higher, I mean. Global economy is plunging, though. That's going to be a negative force to our GDP. But most of all, our debt is steadily declining, which is good. Like, we had a couple quarters where it was doing bad, but now we have it down to 74% of GDP, which is good. Of course, our popularity right now is overwhelming. It's even overwhelming among liberals. So, see, it's like, well, we're about halfway through. I don't know if I'm gonna play this thing all the way to the election. You know, well, let's go all the way to when we're able to lower taxes. So, like, we want to have all these transitional things, right? Like, now we can do the technology colleges, because we want to focus more on the technology college side, right? Oh, no, we can't raise this. So, see, this is, see, we can afford to do this now. Like, you go science funding. And that's going to reduce unemployment, create more. Well, this is actually, yeah, this is how much they like us. That's not. But, yeah, we're going to increase GDP by doing this. And then we're going to focus on the technology colleges. You know, give them a little bit of an increase. And then next, we're going to do charter schools. But I want to find something cheap to increase. First of all, let's see how these are doing. Alcohol consumption going down more. Internet crime is less of a problem now. Asthma's going down. Narcotics going down steadily. Not as fast as I'd like. Now this is going up. Where's this coming from? Like, our productivity is going down. That's what's causing it to go uncompetitive to come up. So I'm wondering if there's something cheap we can do somewhere here to create that competitive economy, but I don't think there's much of anything we can do. I don't want to do state housing. I mean, I'm for state housing in real life, but I just think there's better ways, I guess. Let's see. Well, the roads, road building still hasn't been reduced to its bottom state yet, so, you know, there's still some things we gotta wait on. Oh, here's one thing we can do. You guys are gonna like this one. Private prisons, gone. So we get rid of private prisons, which is good. You're welcome, everybody, because I'm sure you like that. I hate to leave 10 points on the table, but I mean, we get it in the spades anyhow. I mean, because we get a good maximum. Okay, now here's a doctor strike. Here's an example of a new situation that can come up. And here's the global economy that just crashed. As if it wasn't already crashing, but that's... They had a George Bush quote on there, I can't believe that. And our income just got absolutely crushed. Like, our GDP just plummeted because of that global recession. Now here's a doctor's strike. Now what's causing this? See, this is actually the perfect time to have let's see, here's health tax credits. This is actually, I also did this one. That increases health a little bit, but we're gonna yeah, we're gonna go ahead and do this. We're gonna implement the private system. Now, this isn't gonna kill the doctor's strike, but oh, I already got it. Dang it. Oh well. Well, it's what it is. What it is. What can we do again? Let's see. We got. They want the unions. They want the wages are good. The labor laws they don't like too much. Unemployment, state health service. We're not gonna do state health service like they want. Our pollution problem's about gone, though. Our uncompetitive economy is increasing, probably because of productivity. Of course, alcohol consumption going down with GDP. I think I'm gonna end this here because, like, this is basically how you would create a system. Well, no, let's go ahead and turn it over. Because see, we're gonna turn over to the private stuff. Let's see. I wish there's something I could do with this extra 15. Yeah, we're gonna see some of this through, because just so you guys can kind of see the complete picture. Ag subsidies we don't really need. Consumer rights we can go ahead and do. No, we can't because we've only got one. This organic. Now here's something we could do right here. We could do what was? Oh, I don't think I have enough for. Oh, health food, right here. Small cost, a little bit of poor earnings, a little bit of health benefits, and very good stuff. So now we can start, well, we're going to do charter schools, then I think we're going to lower military, and then we can kind of start working on taxes a little bit. So we're going to start, I got 12 left, though. But I kind of have a lot to do, too. So we're going to go ahead and do this. We'll just go ahead and let this one through. Credit rating downgraded, for whatever reason. Now we're BB, and I don't know why. All because our GDP fell. That's a problem, but at least our pollution's ended. Yeah, and our income just took a nasty, nasty hit. Like the other recession I faced is really bad, but this is just crippling. This is worse than the other one I faced. Dr. Strike is going down slowly. But anyhow, so we got our private health. Now we're gonna do, you know, because it's important that we do charter schools as soon as we can do it. This is technology, what am I thinking? Charter, this is state. Oh, voucher, oh, we already have vouchers up there. Let me add the health service. So, how's our unemployed? Because before we lower... Oh, that's going up. Okay, let's look through here again what we're gonna do. Childhood, child benefit, all that. Clean energy, consumer rights, maternity, we're gonna tax shelters, oil drilling. I really hate the idea of oil drilling subsidies, and it's very expensive. But I think we're gonna do tax shelters, because that's gonna help GDP. So, you know, sorry socialists, sorry equality, but it's reality. Gotta deal with it. I'm gonna do that. School tax credits. So yeah, we're gonna go ahead and do this. Go ahead and get private schools underway. And we're gonna start lowering pensions, lowering military spending next, I think. So we're gonna do that. Okay, so here's a landmine ban. Well, see, this is something I'm not, you know, because if they want to, people want to buy mines, they can buy mines, you know, it's up to people. That is what you do. Let's see, our expenditure's starting to run through the roof, so yeah, we're going to go ahead and, lower military to something a little lighter, about a little over 100 billion. And what's it going to cost to lower pensions? We're going to do that next. Let's look at, okay, our tax minister hates us right now. I'm almost considering reshuffling the cabinet. But I probably won't reshuffle it. I think I'll deal with 25 because there's not much else that we can gain. So we're gonna do that. And then next we're gonna lower, let's go ahead and raise the stamps. I mean, might as well have something small to do. It's just something I wouldn't mind in real life too, because it's like, you know, what do people get in stamps? Like, it's almost nothing. And we just got an earthquake. As if we did not need that. Okay, asthma and internet crime are now at an end, but we got another credit rating downgrade. So now we're back to B. So, we're dealing with huge, things here. So, now we can lower pensions. See, this will actually increase private pensions too, which will help dramatically. Because that way the government doesn't have to get involved and tax people for it. The poor won't like me as much, the retired won't like me as much, poverty, will be negatively impacted, but it's costing us a ton of money, so we're gonna keep, we'll keep the policy there, of course, but we just want to, get these costs under control, if you see what I mean. Rent control, clean air, okay. Click next. Return to government. Uncompetitive economy. Somehow at an end, even with all this GDP. Software patents, no. Well, you gotta be able to do your own business, your own marketing. Look at our popularity. You want to talk about popular? Holy smokes. Now, private healthcare is, I don't really want to increase any spending. To be honest, I kind of want... See, we need, see, I like to have more tax breaks, but, there's not really a lot else I can do. Oh, here's, okay, this is the better one, this is the vouchers, so I'll go ahead and do, we'll do something like this. We don't have to go bananas. But yeah, we've lowering, border controls aren't too bad. See, there's not really a lot of groups that really hate us. Motorists hate us, of course. And socialists hate us. Let's see, the drug epidemic's kind of going up again. Yeah, a lot of that's going to be tied to GDP, just natural. Okay. So right now our GDP is kind of crippled, bad. Is there anything else we can get? I can do free bus passes, but really, it's like... Like, let's kind of look at some of this stuff. Let's see, unemployment's going way up because of GDP. Currency strength, not too concerned about it. GDP, up and down, we've already looked at that. Wages, slightly higher, but earthquakes and recessions are killing us. Tourism, that's something we want to do in the very long term. But that won't be with you guys. Technology increasing, but close to being maxed out. Working week decreased, but still high. I just clicked on that. Energy efficiency. Yeah, see, so unemployment's already almost up there. The environment is really, really good right now. What you want. I believe in environmental laws, like if you can reduce regulations elsewhere, such as on businesses and such, it's always a good thing. Now here's one thing I'd love to do, the holy grail, is to eliminate the capital gains tax. But I don't know if we have the political capital to do it. Here's corporate tax. It's kind of massive. I don't want to. That kind of gives us income. Wealthy don't like that, but really, it's like you kind of got to be concerned with let's see. I don't even know what the point of keeping that petrol tax is, but it's too expensive to remove, so we're just going to keep it. Enterprise, health tax credits we just looked at, here's capital gains, now we could cancel it, now GDP, and self-employed, high earnings. So we're going to remove the capital gains and spend $50 billion on that. But see, it's like I said, this is, you have all but banished the thought of any other political parties from the minds of the electorate. Other politicians, the mere has-beens. Now we're triple C in credit. We may be forced to raise taxes because this is going to kind of get out of control. At least until our defense gets down. And see, that's what's killing us is, like, until our GDP gets up there, our income is going to be kind of garbage. See, here's education. Education is nearly maxed out. Especially with private schools. But see, this is the thing. It's like, that's what you want to do, and then, you know, you want to create your economic base. You know, that's the whole plan, and then you can lower taxes. You know, right now we're just not in a position to do that. See, the pensions have taken effect. Military spending's gonna take longer to do. But anyhow, I think this is a good place to end it, because it would actually take a few turns to change this. So we're gonna go ahead and save this in case I want to do another episode. I might do it tonight, I might do it tomorrow, whatever. I might never do it, for all I know. But we're going to save this, and we'll save this to YouTube. So save that, return to government, and we'll go ahead and quit the main menu, and we will exit this out. And thank you guys for listening, and God bless.